I have just a couple of things I want to share related to our upcoming return to in-person worship next Sunday. We've been sharing it as a projected date. We are still on that track and looking forward to gathering not only in person, but also continuing on live stream. I want to remind you, brothers and sisters, that if you're not yet comfortable returning to worship, or if you're part of a higher risk population and you would like to remain home, you can continue worshiping with us via live stream. This gift of digital connection is going to be a part of our ministry moving forward. And so I praise God for that and look forward to finding ways to stay connected for those of you that aren't able to be with us physically in person. Also want to share with you just a couple of things, three in fact, from what I shared last week. Just real succinctly, you have to know this if you are considering coming next Sunday for in-person worship here at Covenant. We are focused on creating a no-contact environment and limiting capacity to 100 persons or less in our space. And in order to do that, here are the three things you need to hear. Number one, schedule change. Our schedule is not going to be 9, 10:30, and noon. You need to hear this. You ready? 9, 11, and 1 o'clock for Spanish. And so if you show up at 10:30, you're going to have a long wait. And I want you to hear that. 9, 11, 1 o'clock Spanish. Second, there will not be childcare. And our Cove Kids ministry will be digitally offered in the sanctuary, so families will worship together. I think it's a glorious chance for us to gather together in that way. I want you to know that your kids will not be a distraction to me. It's going to be a gift to have them with us. There will be no childcare. Number three, we will be taking RSVPs for worship in order to maintain that 100-person capacity. We will take RSVPs. So, brothers and sisters, I want you to know that reservations for next Sunday's worship service, May the 24th, will open today at 4 o'clock in the afternoon. And there are two ways that you can RSVP. These are your two ways. Number one, the Church Center app. If you haven't gotten the app yet, I really recommend you do so. It's a great way for you to stay connected with what's going on, events. You could RSVP for worship. You could check in for worship. You could give to the ministry of the church. All that's available, the Church Center app. There are three steps. All you do, click on the app, go to the events, click register, and it'll walk you through that. Simple as that. Number two, the second way that you could register RSVP for worship is you could go to covenantconnects.life, our website, and there on the homepage it says register for in-person worship. You could click that button and you will find your way there. Brothers and sisters, we are creating this RSVP process so that we can ensure we are creating a worship experience that is as safe as possible. And so it is critical for us to be able to do that. I know you. I know our community, and I know that we are not an early committing, reservation giving, RSVPing people. That is going to have to change. Here's why. Well, here's what I'm going to tell you. If you RSVP sometime between today at 4 and Wednesday, we're going to have an in-person worship service for you. Right now, we're projecting 2 English, 9 and 11. But if there, let's say, brothers and sisters, there's 800 people that want to come worship next week. I promise you, if 800 RSVP by Wednesday, I will preach 8 times to accommodate that. I might not have a voice, I might not be able to stand, but we'll figure it out, okay? So if you RSVP on Wednesday, there's going to be a space for you, even if we have to open additional services. But after Wednesday, we're just going to fill up to capacity, and once capacity is overrun, then we'll just have to continue this live stream ministry for those that didn't make it in by Wednesday. So please, if you're interested in coming to in-person worship, go ahead and get on this week, beginning today at 4 through Wednesday. All right. One last thing that I want to be sure you hear. Some of you might have some questions about our return to worship plan. We released it last Sunday. And you might have gone online, you've read it, you've perused it, you rewatched my announcement last week 4 times to catch all of the details because I was so long-winded and verbose. What can I say? I'm a preacher, right? So it's a fatal flaw. I'm sorry about that. But brothers and sisters, you might have some questions remaining. Today at 1:30, we're going to go live for a Q&A, Pastor Zach and myself, here in this space. And if you have questions, you could jump on that live. You could ask your questions. We would love to be in that dialogue with you because we don't want you to feel like your voice hasn't been heard or you're questioning whether or not we've taken everything into consideration. And we might not have. We're doing our very best. But if we need to consider something else, we would love to receive your insight and your questions today at 1:30. So all of that said, we're going to continue to gather together in live stream worship. We're also going to continue beginning next Sunday with in-person worship here in this space.